You actually saw this in your For You page, but it was in my For You page as well, which means it's a For Us page, and that's why we're married. How beautiful. Anyway, it's a video of this guy. Apparently, the wife has terminal cancer, right? Is that what it is?
Yeah.
And he's just berating her, like, horribly. The kids are upset. It's wild, bro. So we're going to play it for you. We're going to upset you guys as much as we got upset by watching it. That is crazy that I even did that. Let's go. Oh, it's not even active. Let's go.
I hate you, Catherine. Damn. I hate you. I regret every minute of my life the fact that I met you.
This is quite possibly one of the most heartbreaking videos that I have ever created.
Can I just say, though? I know that, like, I'm a buzzkill, but this guy annoys me.
Why?
Because I watched this video already, and he's just, like, pretends to cry.
Does he?
It seems like he has this, like, intentional somber tone. Like, I get it. Like, we shouldn't be like, hey, guys, look at this video here. Drop the beat. And then play, like, you know. Beep, 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 beep. Exactly. We shouldn't be doing that. That's inappropriate. But at the same time, it feels forced to me.
Mm.
You know, it feels a little performative. Not that he's a bad guy. It's just, like, the weird way the internet works.
And it does not have a happy ending. And with that, I give an extreme trigger warning.
So you hate you, and I'll be filing for divorce as soon as I possibly can.
Jesus. In this video is Alan Kassenhoff. It may be pronounced Kassenhoff, but I could not confirm that. In bed is his wife, Catherine. She had just had surgery from breast cancer a couple of days prior. Take a listen.
I'm not taking her. She's spoiled. And I'm not taking her. She will be punished by not going today.
You're her
She's
parent.
By, I'm not
and
taking her.
You need to
her.
Take her to school.
No, I'm not.
I cannot do it. I'm
then
in
she
bed.
Won't go.
I'm lying in bed. I can't
then
do it.
Get her
I can't
out of drive. Bed.
You take her to school, please.
Get her out of bed, and I'll take
Stop
her.
Stop talking that horrible way to her.
Get her out of bed.
No.
She's spoiled.
You.
And I'm not dealing with her anymore. I will no longer take her to activities over the weekend. I will no longer do nice things for her. She will be treated the way
this
everyone
is
else
school,
is treated.
And you need.
Why do you think he's acting like this?
Because he's a big ninny boy.
Okay. No, but I mean, like, why? I don't get it. Like, what do you think is going through his head that's making him berate his wife and to the point where he's not going to take his own child to a place of learning?
Because he's a big man, baby, and he doesn't know how to handle his emotions and therefore cannot deal with...
But what
like
emotion
the behavior
is he experiencing?
Of a child, frustration.
But like, over
that your
what?
Kid won't get out of bed.
That's you think that's what it is?
That's what I mean. He has issues, obviously, but yeah, that's what he's mad about right now. That his daughter's not getting up for school.
Because I can understand, like, if his wife has cancer, I can see why he could be frustrated because that could be rough. But like, this is insane. I would just be moody and I'd fart a lot or something.
No, this guy's a big piece of shit.
Yeah, I just don't get it because like usually I can see where people are coming from. But this guy's like a psychopath.
Yeah.
Despite her multiple battles with cancer, the abuse continues. And it all happens right in...
She's got to fight the cancer and her husband at the same time. How terrible is that?
In front of their...
It's damn. It's tragic. Sorry. That's inappropriate.
Children.
Yeah, they will come.
I'm leaving.
Take your daughter. Go in there and say you're sorry.
No!
Say you're sorry.
No! No!
No! Say you're sorry.
No!
Bro, he's literally a little kid running down to his bedroom, like in the basement.
I could never.
I don't understand. That's like me when I was like 14. I was like, no, mom.
Yeah. I could never. That's the type of man that you just laugh at him.
No, he'd catch a couple stacks, you know?
money?
He would catch a call. Yeah, sure. That's what I meant. Definitely. This is insane.
Stop it!
I do like the hippo thing though that they had the point.
Stop, Allie!
Do not talk to Allie like that.
Stop! He left.
Allie,
come here.
Recently, Catherine was diagnosed with more cancer.
Damn.
This time, it was terminal. But that doesn't stop Alan.
Let's try to calm him down.
Alan, I have to go to my doctor now.
I'm leaving.
I don't care.
Bro, I'm going to be honest with you. Like, if you got diagnosed with terminal cancer, we got diagnosed with terminal cancer.
Oh, yeah, 100%.
I'd be devastated. Sometimes I can't even sleep through the night. I can't even sleep through the night sometimes thinking about, like, our future because one day this is going to end, you know? I know that's really sad.
No, I know. I thought we told each other we weren't going to talk about it or think about it.
Sorry, don't get upset. I'm laughing because I'm upset. You're crying because you're upset.
I'm going to cry.
It's a sad thing. You know, there's nights where I'll be on my phone and I'll be sitting there and I'm just laying next to you. I'm like loving up on you and you're cute. Like we're touching butts. You know what I mean? We're touching butts and we're farting on each other. And then like I'll touch you and then I'll have like the thought of like, oh, I don't know how many moments I'm going to have like this. And I'll put my phone down and just
cuddle
you.
I'm going to cry right now. I'm crying right now.
Isn't it terrible?
It's so horrible.
Baby, I'm a little teary-eyed
so
too.
There was one day I was at work and baby, it's remember okay. I snapped you because I made myself start hysterically crying.
Uh-huh.
Because when we leave the house, he gives me special kisses.
Yes.
Goodbye kisses.
Yes. Yeah.
I thought about how one day.
No, just stop.
They'll be like the last one. I'm literally crying.
Oh my God. This is terrible. You're terrible. I know what you mean. That is a sad thought.
It's so sad to think about. And then you have like big old pieces of shit like this. But like, I wonder what's going on. Maybe I'm just too judgmental.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I mean, listen, because
it's like I know she has cancer, but like, what are you doing?
Like what's going on in between the filming?
Well, no. Like, why? I don't know. It would surprise me if this behavior was unique to the cancer situation.
Okay.
So, like, I just question, like, what barriers may have been in place for her to not be able to leave?
I got what you're saying. Like, how come she didn't leave the situation earlier kind of a thing?
Especially
but not in a way children. That's like, fuck her. Like, what you said, like, what barriers were in place? What would have prevented her from leaving?
Yeah.
You know? I don't know. Well, yeah, I know you cried a little bit. Yeah, it's an interesting scenario, but either way, like none of this behavior is justifiable because it's so hard because I want to understand, like, why is he this frustrated to this extent? You know, what's the what's the behavior that's going on? Like, why is this behavior happening?
This behavior shows that he is a man not meant to be a father, maybe for even sure. a husband.
Or maybe he could have been better off as a little puppy or an alligator. Yeah,
but I do feel like there's people that are not meant to. There's obviously people that are not meant to be, most definitely parents, and maybe even sometimes like a spouse. And like that's okay, but I think that family values and traditions push you to do those things.
Yeah.
And then stuff like this happens.
Yeah, I get what you're saying. Like there's an expectation that's like built up onto this guy to this point. But I mean, it's one thing to be angry, but like how horrible is this? I mean, your kids are screaming, you're storming out of the house, you're acting like a fucking belligerent piece of shit. What a terrible thing. And like I was saying before, I've been in bad relationships. I think we all have. And they brought the worst out of me where I've been like not my best self. But this is insane. Like I've never had this, you know, colossal meltdown.
Yeah.
It's crazy. So let me continue. Bye,
I am leaving.
Bye,
I'm not dealing with these
kids anymore. That's what you don't get. You're not dealing with these kids anymore?
Are they not
They're
his
your kids? Children. Okay, I have violin practice to do with Charlotte.
Well, now I get it. She has the audacity to have cancer and want to play violin. Now I understand why the husband's upset.
She's doing the violin lessons with her daughter.
I was making a joke, but is that what she said?
Yeah, it's because she says with Charlotte.
Oh, well, this is why I need you, because you listen, and I'm the funny guy, and you're the serious guy, girl.
I'm the serious guy?
I'm the funny girl. Girl, it's so bad because girls are not funny. Do you remember like the Monsters Inc. movie where there's like the guy with like eight arms playing and trying to like hit like fart things with a mallet, like puppy cushions with a mallet?
What?
There is a meme I saw where it was from Monsters Incorporated, and there's a scene where like they're trying to make people laugh now. So it might be like Monsters, some other Monsters movie, but. Or at the show, and he's hitting a bunch of whoopee cushions with a mallet to make it fart. And like the caption said, when your girlfriend's trying to be funny.
<That's> funny.
I didn't say it to you because I thought it would be too mean.
That's funny. I am funny, though.
Yeah, funny looking. Nah, I'm kidding. You're very beautiful. I love you.
I knew it.
No. Okay, let's go.
Fat loser.
What'd you call me?
A fat loser.
Jesus.
One more time.
A Look fat old loser who I
Wait,
hate.
Wait, what are you in fucking fourth grade?
My thing is that it's very obvious that she's even recording and he still doesn't hold back.
Yeah.
Like, he doesn't care at all. It's crazy.
Say again. Keep going.
Despite this evidence, Alan had Catherine arrested in 2022. Catherine fought the false allegations, and the courts believed her. And they dropped everything that she was charged with.
When the piano started playing, did it lose you a little bit?
You know? No.
But this is the heartbreaking part.
Okay.
In a post made a few days ago by Catherine, this is what she says. It is with profound heartbreak that I hope none of you experience. Today I am writing that this is my last post ever. Today is the end.
No better for kids. What? Bro, I know it's a little much from the guy, right?
Yeah.
This is a horrible situation, but like when he overlays the piano and he starts like fake crying, because it's upsetting for sure, but like when it's so performative, it fucks.
You weren't supposed to turn around.
Everybody could already tell that he was making you cringe. I told you, it's too much. Like, it's the narration is fine, but like the degree.
Well, I was gonna have a conversation about that part of it after we got through the actual.
Oh, you want to talk about the performance? Okay, we'll talk about that after.
Catherine, I hate you. I hate you. I'm trying to shower. You're barging in. I want privacy. Did someone tell you? Well, you know better. Get out there. I'll deal with it. Don't ask us.
I was going to make a joke about how you're always in the bathroom when I'm showering and you stare through the curtain while I shower. Like, the shower curtain's like a bodysuit for you while you stare at me.
Yeah.
And this guy's complaining because she's in there with him. Bro, we take shits while the other way. You literally came downstairs yesterday. You came home and I started showering. And you came downstairs just to take a big fat shit in the room I was showering. I was like, baby, really? And you're like, yeah, I miss you. And that was it. That you missed me.
I had to tell you something.
Yeah. So, but this guy, this is crazy.
Yes! Guys, you know what she said? She told me. This thing told me.
Jesus.
I'm so done with you.
Charlie, can you please try to get out of bed?
I don't want to go with crazy guy! I am not ever going with him.
What's that stuff? Yusuf Kasanoff. Interesting. How old was she? That's 31, 40, 54? Damn. Sad stuff. Is it like 4 seconds more? Okay. So
I hate you.
So first of all, that's horrible that the kids said they don't want to go with that thing. Like, he's a real piece of shit for them to be that afraid.
I just have so many questions about it.
Yeah, go ahead.
And one of them being, why does this guy,
which guy,
the host of the video,
gotcha,
say that she's dead?
I think that she died.
How do we know?
Because I believe at the end, like, he showed her Facebook story or something that she's dead.
Oh.
And she has terminal cancer, so I think she died.
Maybe.
Yeah.
I just don't understand. We actually, I sent you another video, but it was different than this because the other girl was just being a brat, in my opinion.
Oh, but the husband-wife thing you're talking about?
Yeah.
You want to talk about that one, too?
Maybe. It's just, like, interesting that this is getting posted on TikTok.
Okay.
Like, all of her videos. Because again, like, I'm not, this is a hard conversation to have,
yeah, well,
but I'm
that's
honestly
what we try
looking
to do here.
At it, like, I guess, like, professionally, like, what is the goal of posting the information, you know?
What was that?
What is the goal of posting the information, posting the videos?
Right. Well, I get what you're saying is that because we talked about this, and like when you're in your field, especially, you have to humanize inhuman behavior sometimes, right? From a clinical perspective. So I know that that's kind of the perspective we're approaching this from.
Well, more of like, I don't want people to interpret me as being like victim blaming or something.
No, no, no. That's what I'm saying to people is that like, these are the questions, but these questions that we might ask or the way that we have a frame of thought on this isn't to be like invalidating of her or anything. It's just like, what's going on? Like, what's the behavior that's happening? What is causing this, that, and the other thing? Mm-hmm. And part of it's like trying to rationalize, well, frankly, irrational behavior. Which I think that is, but like, yeah, let's keep, yeah, continue. Sorry. What were you?
So like, I question why like the videos are being posted to TikTok. Like, what is that doing? I question like other like family involvement or whatever, because if you're dying, your children are going to be left to their father.
Yeah.
And I feel like a lot of times, like maybe I'm gonna whatever. I think like men have the choice to walk away from their families. I mean, like, obviously.
Okay.
But like, I guess just parents in general, you could relinquish your parental rights.
From his perspective, like, why doesn't he relinquish them?
And I feel like people don't, okay, when they should. So basically what I'm saying is that like, this woman's dying, leaving her kids. This guy should be like, fuck them kids. I relinquish my parental rights.
Yeah, I mean, even though that's
a tough decision to make.
Clearly it's not for him. I mean, he doesn't seem to, you know. So as far as what's on TikTok, I think that she probably recorded it to put it up because of what's going on.
Yeah, I know, but that's what I'm saying. Like, TikTok is not the place. TikTok is not going to intervene and make your children's lives better.
No, it's not. Well, because this gets into a whole conversation about, we talked about it. I got to come up with a better name, but like the whole conversation about like virtue bullying and about how people, they'll see people that are doing clearly bad things. Like, for instance, I saw some good guy that was like really drunk and he was in like a Chinese food place. It seemed like he was being belligerent, possibly like a bit racist, and it was really bad. But people will take his video, and that's not good. He shouldn't be doing that. You shouldn't be an alcoholic. You shouldn't be drunk. You shouldn't be belligerent. People found out where he lived. They found out his previous arrest records, and like, they're just berating him on the internet. And it's like, well, that's not helpful. You're just, you just feel good about bullying somebody that you feel deserves it. It gives you a sense of self-worth to attack other people, and you don't actually care that they did a bad thing. In fact, a lot of these people want people to do bad things, mm-hmm, because they want content, and they make all this money from you know, pushing this content. Even though from like a more educated perspective, there needs to be better interventions, which is really just like a prioritization of social work. But if you press them on any social justice topic when it comes to prison reform, they're like, oh yeah, we need to reform that. But then when it comes to a guy that's been in and out of jail because he's an alcoholic, because we have really weak support systems for people who are substance abusers, it doesn't matter anymore because we want to bully the individual. It's an incredible case of cognitive dissonance. For this case though, I don't think that I see that. It's more of the mother doing social awareness so that CPS might get involved. Like, you remember that stupid family that, excuse me, Saran wrapped their kid and like threw him around a little bit in bed, like that silly little prank they did on their kid. His kids, yeah, seemed to be upset or whatever. People called CPS on them, which was fucked up.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah.
But CPS got called.
Yeah.
And so from her perspective, I can see why she's doing it. I think she's like, this is one of the very few times where I feel like this is an appropriate thing. As long as the outcome is like the court system gets involved. I know that it's a flawed system overall, but it's better than the social court system.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's what I think. I mean, overall, it's horrible. I can't find any way to rationalize the behavior at all. Like, I'll sometimes see people who are very angry and have disproportionate responses, but I can see why they're angry. And so I can look and go like, okay, I get it, but this is still wrong. The response to being upset is, you know, not appropriate, but I get it. This I don't get.
It's just embarrassing.
I guess, yeah.
Honestly,
I think he's abusive.
This man as a person is embarrassing.
Yeah. It's pretty fucking crazy. I don't know if there's like an update. What do you think though? Just on the thought, based on the situation, what do you think about the concept of people trying to get him to lose his job? Like, if that is something people are trying to do. Oh, there's an update on the guy. Oh, wait, there's
a lawyer. I know somebody found that.
He's a lawyer?
Yeah.
Damn, there's apparently updates. Wait, I kind of want to see this.
You, Catherine? I hate you. I regret every minute of my life the fact that I met you.
Well, if he's a lawyer, it makes sense now why he's an asshole.
You saw my video of Alan Kasanoff and his abuse towards his wife. Yep. Now that attention has been brought to the story, a lot of details are coming out. So I want to take this time to dig deeper into the story and update you on where we're at. Now, Alan and Catherine got married back in 2006. Okay. Catherine alleges the abuse began back in 2016, so badly that it required medical attention.
That's interesting. Is that normal for abuse, for somebody to become an abusive person, and that's not like a general behavior that they engage in permanently?
It sounds probably around the time that their children were born.
Or maybe Donald Trump. Maybe Donald Trump made him abusive.
Maybe.
Maybe he became a real MAGA star. You know, I'm sorry. That's very inappropriate. I'm sorry. That's really crazy. Because I felt like you would just always be shit. That's interesting. You must like hate kids.
Well, I have to say, like, she... He seems to be like a really bad father, and she was 54.
Yeah, well, I think
and
that
she has those three children look like under 10, like 10 and under, maybe.
Okay.
So that would make me believe that maybe they weren't successful having children for a long time or something, or that they were at least childless for a long time.
Okay. Well, yeah. I could see why she couldn't escape the situation or escape, you know what I mean? Given the fact that like they had kids together, I think that makes it very difficult. But that is actually an interesting concept that, like, you think that maybe they didn't want kids? Because I know for my mother and my father, you said no, that you don't think that that's the...
I don't know that much, but like I said, what I'm assuming is that they were childless for a long time.
Right, and she was, like, in her 40s when they had a kid. So it's possible, like, because I was going to say, like, when my mother and father were married, and my mother had problems giving, like, having a baby. And so my mom, like, my father was like, I'm just not going to work on it. I don't care. Even though apparently, clearly he didn't want kids. And then I became a seed. The seed was planted. And then that's when he started, like, I want to get out of here. So I wonder if it's almost like that. Like, maybe she had complications and then he's like, I don't want kids. And so then all of a sudden it happened. But then three. I mean, that doesn't make any sense then, because you have like three kids. I don't know. Okay.
Violin practice to do with Charlotte.
Okay, fat loser.
Damn.
What'd you call me?
A fat loser.
As a response to her accusations, Alan began accusing Catherine of manipulating their children. Okay. So they would hate him and make up stories about what he does.
Well, it makes sense. I mean, I might hate you just for the way you're acting. It's kind of a hard sell since he's acting like a fucking animal.
To Catherine.
Hate you, and I'll be filing for divorce as soon as I possibly can. I'm not coming home this weekend. I'm going to be away. I will come back Sunday to get my stuff for next week.
Okay. Alan also began spying on Catherine, reading all of her text messages and emails between friends, family, and even attorneys. Now, keep in mind, Alan and Catherine are attorneys. They understand the system. Catherine focused more on raising their kids once they were born, but Alan was actively practicing law.
If it's not perfect, I will dump it again. Do you understand?
Yes.
And you do not have 4 hours to do it. You will have 40 minutes. I can clean this up in 10. Do you understand me?
Yes.
That's not how you're supposed to get your kids to clean, right? That seems very abusive. I came from a pretty strict home life, too, and that my mom didn't do that stuff to me. One time I threw up and my aunt told me I had to eat it because she was angry, but I didn't eat it. My aunt's a little mean, huh? But thankfully I didn't have to eat it. That was probably kind of a fucked up thing that happened to me. Nah, not a big deal.
Alan took select messages, 11 of them, to a judge and got a temporary custody order. Catherine had no say.
Why would he want his kids? He doesn't even like his kids. It seems like he wants to weaponize the children at this point. Right? That makes sense.
Was not heard during that hearing. That was back in 2019. And then in 2020, Alan got another order against.
It makes even more sense why she's recording, though, now that we have, like, now we're getting there. Because, like, like, this is one of those, like, almost pale, like, holy grail moments where this woman is, like, 1,000% in the right. Because he's like, how many people will have an instance in their life and they'll, like, weaponize it, you know? But she's like, it seems like she's like 1,000% in the right here.
Yeah.
There's nothing you know.
Catherine, forcing her to leave their residence immediately.
They won't go with you like this.
Then they're not going to school.
You need to calm down.
Shut up!
You can't talk like this to them.
Shut up!
I can't leave them here with
Shut
you.
Up! You're
in July of 2020, Alan got another order of protection against Catherine, preventing her from seeing their children completely.
Damn.
Catherine fought that and proved her case. And the protection of order was dropped.
Wait, how would they even get in the first place? Like, what evidence did he have that he would even get the ability to separate another parent, especially the mom, frankly, from being able to see their own kids? Like, what? That's what I'm curious about.
But now her visitations were supervised, and it was costing Catherine a lot of money.
What, but like, I mean, I don't mean to be skeptical. I'm just curious, like, how did he, I mean, he's a lawyer, so maybe he has a little bit of in, but how did he get an order of protection? And then even when it got reduced, it was reduced down to like supervision.
Yeah.
Like, what information did he, I'm just curious about it, because is it possible we're dealing with two shitty people? Maybe he's just shittier. I'm not saying that's a fact. I'm curious about that.
In 2021, the oldest daughter ran away from Alan twice to go live with Catherine. The courts ordered her back to their father immediately.
Charlie, can you please try to get out of bed?
I don't want to go with crazy guy! I am not ever going with him.
And then as Catherine was getting back on her feet, she rented an
So somebody in the chat said that apparently she didn't pass to the cancer, but she took her own life. I don't know if that's true, but that's what they had mentioned in the chat.
Apartment, a mile away from the kids, so she could see them more often. Alan got another order of protection against Catherine. Once again, another hearing where she was not allowed to present her case, allegedly. And that order of protection was granted.
That doesn't make sense to me, especially since they're both lawyers and they understand the system. How is she get, like, how is that happening?
I don't know. That's what I'm saying. Like, there's no denying that this guy's like a piece of shit.
And you shouldn't have kids.
Like, I want to know the full story.
I feel like we're missing a lot. It doesn't justify his behavior, but.
No.
What's going on with Catherine? Like, I understand that the court's system can be flawed at times, but like, how is it that she's constantly losing her kids in the court system? What information does this guy have?
Yeah.
It's interesting.
And Catherine was forced to leave her home once again.
Are these like relevant videos, or is he just like mixing in the old
videos? These are the same videos from the last.
Yeah, like are these in like some kind of chronological order? Are they associated with what's going on in the timeline, or is he just putting them in there to kind of
probably emphasize?
Probably, yeah. I think that's what I think too.
Yeah, they will come. They will come.
I'm leaving.
Take your daughter, go in there and say you're sorry. Say you're sorry.
No! No!
No!
Say you're sorry.
No!
Stop it!
Just stop, right. Allie!
Do not talk to Allie like that.
Over the next couple of years, the battle goes back and forth, and there are a lot of details that I am not going through that you can go check up on yourself, but it involves different attorneys, different judges, different therapists, and apparently a lot of corruption. More protection orders were filed, millions of dollars were spent.
Why corruption?
Catherine was fired from her job, and now a terminal cancer diagnosis. This is getting
the performance is really annoying to me.
Yeah.
It breaks up the story. It hurts the story. Like, I understand getting upset, but like, it's just very, it's very.
Do you think people respond to that? That's what I wanted to ask you.
Obviously we are in the.
No,
in,
but I mean the people, does it make people.
Yeah,
like, feel?
I think so. I think people think that he's being genuine, but it's very clearly like a performative thing. I mean, you could take that, the music, the way he's cutting up the videos. Where he's like inserting clips we've already seen in the video, not because they're in some kind of chronological order, but that's the right term, right? Chronological, but because it furthers the video, it makes it more entertaining. That's what he's looking for, entertainment value.
Yeah.
Frankly, I don't know. There's more that's going on to this. You know, it's not, the courts will be the ones to decide, because what the fuck are we going to do? Like you said before. But There seems to be something going on here.
Her third battle with cancer. This would be the final one.
Yes or no?
Can you just put on pants? I find it disgusting when you walk around in your underwear.
Alan, this is my home, okay, and I'm getting changed as fast as I can.
I'll post it on YouTube.
You'll do what? You're going to post me on YouTube?
If you think this is appropriate for... I'm not your husband. I have no relationship
to you.
You're
not my husband?
No, we're getting
a
divorce.
Who are you?
I live in a separate room as you. Every time I go in there to help JoJo change, you start flipping out. I'm changing! So I'd appreciate it if you could put on clothing.
I'm not sure what the problem is. I'm standing here in my pajamas.
No, you're wearing underpants.
I'm not sure what the problem is. You're going to post me on YouTube?
Maybe.
I'm going to send this one over.
There were.
I don't know, man. I'm starting to get like weird vibes of the whole situation.
Over 3,000 court filings in this case. And despite all of the accusations, Catherine had proof from doctors that she was mentally stable.
Okay.
She was sane. There was nothing wrong with her.
Alan, I have to go to my doctor now.
Can you get proof of that? Like, I guess you could. Okay.
I'm leaving.
I don't care.
That's what you don't understand.
You need to calm down.
I'm leaving. I am leaving. Bye, Alan. I'm not dealing with these things.
In May of 2020, a judge ordered Catherine to never see her children again.
You need to cry?
And that's when Catherine decided.
It's just so performative. I'm so sorry. I don't mean to be an asshole.
She was tired of fighting.
Okay, she took her own life.
Before Catherine ended it, she uploaded all the footage to a leak, along with court documents, doctor's notes, affidavits, testimonies from friends.
Okay.
And she released that link to everyone.
Oh, where is it?
She wanted the world to see Alan's abuse.
You guys, you know what she said? She told me. This thing told me.
I'm so dumb.
Now, Alan has custody of the kids. But I am told, and this is just what I'm told, I haven't seen any evidence or statements from anybody. But I am told, because of my video and other videos, Alan is now under investigation.
Well, that's good. What link is they talking about?
I know there are many sides to a story. The video footage doesn't lie.
God, this guy's so annoying to me.
And that monster has possession of these children. So I'm going to keep talking about it.
I hate you, Catherine.
Now, there's one more.
Oh!
And then I want to talk about the guy that in the video.
Okay.
Say you're sorry.
No!
Can we just take a second? I swear to God, the way that I would just push that man. Like,
the one yelling?
Yeah.
Just push
like,
him down
the stairs. Like, oh, you want to go downstairs? I'll help you down them.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
Shut the fuck up, you stupid bitch. I just can't believe that.
Yeah, no, it's wild. He's just, like, really acting like a fucking... Like a goober. I don't get it. Where's this like file though that they're referencing? Did he link it?
Alan Kasanoff's story explodes and media and journalists get involved. More details are coming out as to how corrupt this was. So who all was involved in helping Alan Kasanoff destroy his wife? Well, we'll get to that in just a second. But first, to update maybe some of you who don't know about this story.
I hate you, Catherine. It's going to be the same story again.
And his wife, Catherine, had a lengthy divorce and custody battle that cost millions of dollars. And in May of this year, 2023, a judge ruled that Catherine could no longer see her children.
Okay.
Days after that ruling, Catherine decided she was tired of fighting. With a terminal cancer diagnosis, and this ruling, Catherine decided this would be the end for her.
Where is that spoiled kid?
She's not going with you.
Open the gun. Shut up, Allie. Get over there, Allie.
No.
You're not your business. Get over there.
Allie, let me in. Get out, Charlie. Go, Charlie and JoJo.
What is wrong with you? You're not involved in this.
I don't care. She's my sister.
My
But who were the people who decided that the man that you see in these clips should have full...
I will say, it doesn't seem like his kids are afraid of him. They think he's a loser. You know?
Yeah.
All that yelling. Not to be that guy. It's just like all that yelling. I mean, you just can't even command any authority. You shouldn't have to yell. But you know what I mean?
Custody of his children. Judge Louis Lubell ruled that Alan should have full custody of his children, despite never meeting the children himself. He also ruled that Catherine...
Well, why would he need to? Wouldn't he look at, like, professional, like, you know, mental health counselors and whatnot? Like, that... Here's the thing. There could be corruption involved. But, like, so they keep saying corruption and whatnot. I can't even find the file or document. If someone wants to send me, that'd be great. Maybe I'll look at it on my stream myself.
Yeah, I was going to say, like, to be completely honest...
After we're done with this video, at the end of the day, it's up to the system to deal with. And if he's under investigation, that's good. You know, but
no, I was going to say, like, I feel like this is a topic, like, I personally can't have an honest conversation about.
Why?
Because of, like, the headache of social media.
I get what you're saying. Well, I feel like we've been having a decently honest conversation.
Decently, yeah.
But, like, I wonder what, like, what's the evidence of corruption? Him not meeting the kids doesn't really, doesn't matter to me necessarily if he's getting. If they had mental health evaluations or something, you know, but okay.
Evicted from her home without notice, despite it being her home. Judge Lubell was good friends with Dr. Mark Abrams, the custody evaluator assigned to this case. They were such good friends that Judge Lubell officiated over Dr. Abrams' wedding.
Well, that doesn't matter.
And Dr. Abrams ruled that the kids didn't need Catherine as their mother.
Okay.
Catherine fought this ruling and won.
Okay.
And had Dr. Abrams removed from the case.
Okay.
Judge Nancy Quincova, who had never met Catherine or even heard her side of the story, also ruled that the children should stay away from their mother. Carol Most, the attorney for the children, also supported the idea that the kids should be taken away from their mother. And according to reports, Carol Most allegedly made a lot of money being the attorney of the children.
Well, don't all lawyers make too much money being attorneys of everybody?
That's what I'm even wondering, like millions of dollars in these lawsuits?
Yeah, I don't know. But so far, like there could be corruption, but so far none of this sounds different. I mean, I know that in a lot of these circles, judges and whatnot and all these different people are dealing with each other constantly and they become friends in some capacity. There's like coworkers and maybe you could argue some kind of implicit bias or something, but I don't know. It's totally possible that there's this like deep-seated level of corruption that's like getting her, having her kids removed from her. It's also possible that like something's going on with her as well for her to lose her kids. What the dad's doing is still disgusting behavior. That doesn't change that. But I don't know. Okay.
Reports are suggesting that she made almost $300,000.
Okay.
And despite many of these officials being court appointed, they're paid for by the litigants.
Okay.
Alan Kasanoff. Dr. Kathleen McKay became the second custody evaluator of the case after Dr. Abrams was removed. According to reports, Dr. McKay never evaluated Catherine with her children.
Okay.
But she did evaluate Alan and the kids together many times. And guess who was paying her also? Dr. McKay also agreed that Catherine should no longer see her children.
Well, that sounds like to me multiple people were removed probably at this girl's request. And then the new people that came in still agreed that she shouldn't be with her kids or something. Okay.
Even denying Catherine the request to see her kids one last time before cancer took over.
Well,
now one
she took her own life, so that framing is interesting to me. You know what I mean?
That's what I'm saying. I'm honestly, I'm not invested in this.
It's too complicated for people to be like us to even be weighing in on. I think at this point, we're gonna finish this video.
No, and he keeps on like saying like I don't understand. He's leading. Did she kill herself? Did the cancer kill her? Her terminal cancer. Because
that like, suggests that the cancer took her life. When we know that she took her own, which is still a horrible tragedy. But the way that this is framed is intentionally on a side.
Oh, 100%.
And so like.
Oh, Jesus.
So I'm so sorry. I ripped that out of your ear. I'm sorry. So even though it still seems like this guy might be in the wrong, we'll never know because it's not going to be unbiased. And I can't find the link to the whole case. And frankly, I think that this is So loaded that hopefully the court system takes care of it.
Thing to note, Catherine Kasanoff has been an activist for victims of family court for many years.
Okay.
She spoke out over and over again on how unfair family court is.
Okay.
Hence, she did not have a lot of friends in this field.
What? Nothing!
Okay.
We're going to clean this all up today. Perfectly. If it's not perfect, I will dump it again. Do you understand?
Yes.
And you do not have 4 hours to do it. You will have 40 minutes. I can clean this up in 10.
And there are many other players involved in this case. From more attorneys to psychiatrists. A lot of people over the next 4 years. But now you can see how this could happen.
I'm not taking her. I'm not taking her. She's spoiled. And I'm not taking her. She will be punished by not going today.
You're her
She's
parent.
By, I'm not taking her.
And you need to
her.
Take her to school.
No, I'm not.
I cannot do it. I'm
then
in bed.
Then she won't go.
I'm lying in bed. I can't
then
do
get
it.
Get her out
drive.
Of bed.
You take her to school, please.
Get her out of bed and I'll take
Stop
her.
Stop talking that horrible way to her.
Get her out of bed.
No.
She's spoiled.
You.
Get out of bed.
I don't want to go with I that understand. Crazy guy. I am not ever going with him.
The people making the decisions, the people who are supposed to do the best for the children being paid millions of dollars by Alan. Or did Alan have help paying for it? At the time of this filming, okay. Yesterday, Alan's law firm posted this update.
Okay.
They essentially say, after a long court proceeding...
This says, Alan Kasanoff has been involved in divorce and custody matter that has been going on for more than 4 years. After lengthy trials and reviewing all the facts, including some videos, none of the four judges who presided over the trials or two court-appointed neutral forensic evaluators found him to have committed
there was no
wrongdoing or abuse as to his children or the contended domestic violence, and instead awarded him sole legal and physical custody of the three children. Nevertheless, the firm will be conducting their own investigation to determine his status with the firm. In the meantime, he is taking voluntary leave of absence to focus on his family. I just don't know, man. What is possible here is that they're not taking like some of the ways that he acts like as abuse, even though they think they would be considered that. But like the older generations would say, like, if you didn't clean properly and they dumped it on the floor and said, clean up again, like that's not abuse to older. I think I would consider that some form of bad parenting. But that's just considered like hard parenting. You know, the people are like, yeah, he's such a good parent. Oh, it's so cool. But I don't know, man. Four judges, it's possible there's corruption. But to me, it reads as like, you know how people say that like 9/11 was an inside job? Mm-hmm. And it's like, I feel like we would have found out by now. So that would take so many people organizing a situation for that to happen. That like, you know, we know a lot of the government corruption that's going on. Because they're idiots that like let it be known. We just don't care. Like what, like insurance companies like, and all this other stuff. And hospitals like taking so much money for people, like Advil costs like $30 a pill. I just feel like it's possible it's corruption. It's also possible that maybe she's not as good as she's representing herself on. I mean, in the court of law, generally speaking, you advocate for yourself to the fullest degree and the other person advocates themselves to the fullest degree. So she is, of course, going to release information that's going to make her look as good as possible and show his worst moments. It's possible that this is corruption. It's also possible that she has just as many, if not more, worse moments that he has evidence of. Mm-hmm. And that like they're possibly using their children to fight each other over.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't know. But okay.
Alan is innocent. But we'll
that's
invest-
not what it says, but okay.
Investigate just because y'all are upset.
Okay.
The gaslighting in this post really upset me.
Why is it gaslighting? They're saying that they said that like four judges and like two other people all had came to the same conclusion, but we're going to do an internal investigation, which is probably bullshit. It's an internal investigation. But what is that? How is that gaslighting? That doesn't even make sense.
And then it got me wondering, did this law firm help fund Alan's legal fees?
Why? Why would that?
Guys, you know what she's
saying that?
What did he say? Sorry, I was reading the chat.
Alan's law firm. What got me wondering, did this law firm help fund Alan's legal fees.
Oh, why would you think that?
Yes! Guys, you know what she said?
Why would that make you think? Okay. Cool. Cool. And then we're going to play another video we've seen three times because really drive home the point.
She told me. This thing told me.
Like,
I'm so done with you.
Alan knew that Catherine could not afford this type of battle. Catherine gave up her career.
I don't know if that's true. My understanding, and I could be wrong, I'm pretty sure that since they're still married, he has to pay her bills. I'm like 50-50 on that. But I think that he has to pay for her too because it's still their money together. So he's paying both bills.
I don't know how any of it works.
I believe that's how that works.
Career to raise their children. And Alan used the argument that she alienated the children from him. Alan used the family court system to punish his wife.
Maybe.
And those in place designed to help the family, they helped Alan do it.
I need you to fake practice.
Please,
Michael!
Yeah, they will come.
I'm leaving.
Take your daughter. Go in there and say you're sorry.
No! No!
Say you're sorry.
No!
How many times are we going to see this clip over and over again?
Stop it!
This is one of the things I'm questioning. Like,
what's that?
Well, he's being so violent and verbally abusive.
Yeah.
And he's obviously not in a place to have a conversation. Why are you encouraging him to go to your children?
What do you mean by that?
She was just telling him that he needs to go to apologize to their daughter.
Oh, I see what you're saying. Like, consistently, you need to take your daughter to do this. You need to do this.
In this instance, stomping around the house, she's saying you need to go to apologize.
Yes,
to her.
And then before
I would be being like, oh, like you need like go in your bedroom. Your father is being a pussy. You know?
I know what you mean. Well, yeah, and then before there was the moment where she's like, you need to take this kid to go here or something like that. I guess. Or maybe, I mean, I guess. I don't know. Maybe. That's possible.
If you haven't seen it yet, you can find the Frank Report online.
Yeah, what is it called?
I used his journalism and articles for the details of this video.
What's the Frank Report?
There's even more details that he is starting to uncover.
Okay. No!
Okay. Well, that was quite a bit. Oh, it's just a recap of what we already watched from the Frank Report. I don't know, man. Listen, when it comes to this situation, I don't know what's going on, and none of us do. What he's doing is disgusting and insane, absolutely. But on the other hand, I don't know. Maybe there could be corruption, but frankly, it's hard to believe that so many judges would rule against her over and over and over again. So it makes me genuinely wonder what evidence she has. Like, what evidence does he have? What's his information? I don't know. Anyway, the guy who pushed the video, very annoying that he would constantly pretend to cry. That kind of shit's very annoying. It's very performative. I think it gets in the way of the video. And to be absolutely honest with you, nobody that's engaging with this will be neutral because they're all going to be engaging with like their anchor bias. You know, you heard the first bit. The first thing we saw is horrible, what I would consider abusive videos coming from the father, basically. The mother putting them out there, but of the father being a horrible piece of shit. And so now that's the narrative. And there's going to be, it's going to take a lot to push somebody away from that. Mm-hmm. So when I say like, hey, it seems like unlikely that there's corruption or like, I mean, there might be, but it's probably, I don't know. He must have some information. Everybody's like, no, this is how it works. This is always how it works. But frankly, I would argue that this system, custody systems generally favor the women. So like, I find it like a little bit hard to believe that they would take a mother away from their children unless there was something extraordinary going on, you know? I could be wrong, and it doesn't really matter what I say because I don't have I'm not part of the case. But I hope that justice is served.
I hope the girls are okay.
Yeah, that's what I hope that the girls are okay. Not if the man goes to custody, usually the man will win, I guess. Men don't usually win sole custody. So that's not really true. I know what you're referring to. You're specifically referring to the idea that if a man fights for custody, he will, I think it's like 70% of the time, either get sole or joint custody. But I don't know what percentage of sole custody he would get. So, you know.
What do you mean percentage of sole custody? Sole custody is 100.
Okay, yes. Okay. So, my understanding of the information is that 70% of the time that a man fights for custody, he will get either sole or joint custody, which means both of those figures are compounded together. So I'm wondering what percentage of that is sole custody, mm-hmm. and what percentage of that is joint custody in some capacity.